Hi students, we are with the very new chapter thermodynamics. Here entirely every terminology got the different meaning. Okay, so the same word if you use it somewhere else, the meaning will be something else. But in this chapter, if you use it, then the meaning will be something else. Okay, so the topic we are going to start is thermodynamics. Okay. So all of you, I hope, are here with the notebook and pen. Start noting down. Every point is to be noted carefully and followed thoroughly. So for your break only, I have given some ad will be coming and you will be entertained with the good ads, so that you can relax your mind for some seconds and again continue with the same spirit. Okay. So thermodynamics we are going to start. Here, before starting something, what are the words used and what is the purpose of it? What is the difference between general life word and this word? Okay, so those are the some word which is called as a system. Okay, surrounding. What it is? Surrounding and universe. Okay, what is the these three things? System, surrounding and universe. Okay. So here the system in surrounding and universe, if we use in the other subject, they will have some other meaning, but here meaning is entirely different. Let us take a box or a container is kept in a space, okay. So this is a kind of box. Okay, now we are working on the box. Let us take this. Okay. So if I kept in a room at a hot bottle it is, okay, hot bottle it is, or I am drinking it, I am tasting it, let us take, then the part of the universe which is under observation, this is the part of the universe which is under observation, observation, okay, then it is called as a system, okay, then it is called as what? System. And all remaining things, this blue color line, the portion where I am drawing it, okay, where I am drawing it with the blue color lines, okay, this blue color lines is going to affect about the performance of the system. Okay, suppose if you are in a room and studying, that book will become as a system. And if you are in a room with a lot of disturbance, somebody is watching TV, somebody is playing music, so they are all the things which are going to affect your performance. Suppose if you are in a calm and quiet room, then your study will be effective. Okay, so that everything, that sound, noise, video, audio, that all becomes as a surroundings. What it is? Surrounding. Okay. Now that room itself will become as a universe. What it is going to become as? Universe. Okay. So that means this system plus surrounding, yourself, book and all sound, voice, noise and video, everything is called as a universe. So we can simply say that system plus surrounding is equal to universe. The book, yourself is a system. And you are doing some good job, okay, but it can be improved by providing you a silent atmosphere, silent surroundings, or you can be destroyed your concentration by providing a noisy atmosphere and videos showing you, distracting you, keeping a mobile around it. Okay, so that all going to be a surroundings which are going to affect your performance. If something is going on in the neighbor's house and there that sound is not audible, that time it is not surrounding. So the part of the world, the part of the universe which is going to affect the performance of the system, that part only it is called as a surrounding. Okay, and that up to where it is going to affect, different system will have different surroundings. Okay, so there it is called as a universe. System plus surrounding is going to give you universe. Is it understood? Any doubt about this system? Not the any other thing. which is we are general life we are going to use. Here the difference is very very much high. Okay, now we are going to study something about the systems. Okay, because we are going to work on the system, thermodynamic system. Okay, so thermodynamic system is further divided into how many type? Three types. First one is open system. What it is? Open system. Next one is closed system. Next one is isolated system. What system? Isolated system. Okay, let us take a water bottle containing hot water. Let us take this as a containing hot water. Then what happens? And it is cap is open, so water vapor will be going out. That means mass is given by this system into the surroundings. Okay, so this type and this temperature and heat energy will be lost. So that type of system where there are three things you should remember: mass can be given, or matter can be given out, or matter can be given into the system, and heat can be given out and heat can come into the system, or energy can come into the system, or energy can go out from the system. And there is no closed boundaries. What it is not there? Closed boundary is not there. Then it is called as a open system. Okay, mass can be exchanged, energy can be exchanged, and boundary is not closed. Let us take, now I am closing it. Okay, so still this water will get cold after some time. That means heat energy is dissipated from the system to the surrounding. Energy is transferring between the system and surrounding, but water vapor cannot go outside. That is, matter cannot be added to the system, matter cannot be taken out from the system. Okay, and this is because of the closed boundaries. Now everywhere it is closed. Is it understood? But not thermally insulated. Not thermally insulated. So four things you should remember here. Mass cannot be exchanged between the system and surrounding, whereas energy can come into the system. Suppose if you are keeping this bottle in the sun rays, that energy will come into the system and get heated up. Okay, but if you are keeping in a cold room, then heat will go out from this. That means heat given by the energy given by the system to the surrounding. Energy exchange is possible, but not matter exchange, and it got the closed boundaries. Okay, and not thermally insulated boundaries. Understood? That is about the closed system. Now let us take another thing. Okay, so this one, what it is now? Now it is isolated. Mass cannot escape because it has a closed boundaries. Understood? And heat cannot come out because it is a thermally insulated container. Okay, now let us take, I am opening this. Okay, I am opening this. Now the system is converted from dash to dash. What? From cyst. It is converted because of this. It was the closed boundaries. Okay, now it is open boundary. So open boundary means mass can go out and energy can go out, energy can come in, mass can come in. So that can convert it into, now what? Isolated system is transferred to open system. Okay, but if I am closing down, closing it with the normal lid, okay, thermally not insulated lid, then it will become, it is not thermally insulated, then it will become as a closed. What it will become as? Closed. Okay, so let us take a thermally not insulated. Okay, just I will bring it, wait. Okay, now this was the, when it is closed, it is isolated. When it is closed, what it is? Isolated. But when this, it is completely opened without anything, now it will become as a open. But when it is, suppose this is a steel, is a thermally conducting material. If I close this, now it is a closed boundaries, but heat can still can be dissipated. Heat will, dissipation will be minimized but not zero. So now it will become as what? It will become as a closed system. Now it is closed system. Now it is open system and now it will become as a isolated system. Okay, so all the three differences now I think it is clear to you. So thermodynamics is the subject which requires examples, lively examples, so that you can answer the concept based questions easily. Okay, so should I erase this? I will give you the writing. In writing I will give you, so that you should be able to make notes very carefully. Open system, closed system and isolated system. Okay, so there are certain things, mass. Okay, mass can be exchanged, mass cannot be exchanged, mass cannot be exchanged. Okay, energy can be exchanged, closed system energy can be exchanged, and mass, otherwise we can say matter also. What we can say? Matter. Okay, so energy. Then boundaries, about the boundary. Okay, there is no boundary, closed boundary is not there. There are boundaries, there are boundaries, and special condition is the boundaries are thermally insulated. What they are? Thermally insulated. Is it understood? Open system, closed system and isolated system. Like this, if you make proper notes, it is equal to around 5 to 6 pages. Understood? So concise, like a system and surrounding diagram I have given to you and examples I have given to you, with that your concept will be cleared now. Is it understood? So make a note of it. Noted. Then coming to the other type. Okay, let's take the other examples and other properties. There are two types of thermodynamic properties. Okay, what is this? Thermodynamic properties, types. Okay, types of thermodynamic properties. Is it understood? So let us take about the thermodynamic properties. There are two types of thermodynamic properties. There are how many types? Two types of thermodynamic properties. First one is extensive property. What it is? Extensive property. Second one is intensive property. What it is? Second one is intensive property. Extensive property which depends on what? Quantity. Okay, simple intensive will be which is independent of the thermodynamic properties, which are independent of quantity. Independent of what? Quantity. Okay, so then they are called as intensive property. Okay, so let us take one simple example. Let us take this. Okay, this. Understood? Now this is volume, is suppose 5 liter. What it is? Volume is, let us take 5 liter. Okay, and its pressure is 1 atm and temperature is 27 degree Celsius. Okay, what is the temperature? 27 degree Celsius. What is the pressure? 1 atm pressure. And what is the volume? 5 liter. Okay, now the same container is separated into two identical parts. How many identical parts? Two identical parts it is divided, separated by a thermally conducting material. Okay, now what is the volume of this part? Let us take, what is the volume of this part? This will be 2.5 liter, this will be 2.5 liter, and this was total temperature was 27. So what will be temperature here? This side it is 27, that side also it is 27. Even though we are dividing it into two parts, quantity is made half, but temperature is depending on quantity? No. Okay, so temperature is independent of quantity. You make one more part like this also, you make 1/4, 1/5, 1/10, that still temperature is going to be independent of quantity. And what is the pressure? Earlier this, when it is open, that time 1 atm. If I am inserting, what will be the pressure on this side? Still it is 1 atm only. That means pressure is also intensive property. So density, let us take density, it was 1. Okay, now by changing it, what is the density? No change in density. Density is going to same. Let us take it is 5 kgs. Now what will be this half part? It will be 2.5 kgs. So mass is going to be changed, volume is going to be changed, but pressure is not going to change, temperature not going to change, and density not going to change. Okay, so with this example I think it is clear to you. Okay, so another way also I will explain. Okay, let us take this is, this has what, 5 liter container. Okay, and 5 kg, otherwise 5 kg. Okay, so and this was the complete container. Now it is separated into two parts. Okay, now I am talking about this total, it is 5 liter and 5 kg. I am talking about this. Okay, and temperature was 27 degrees Celsius, pressure was 1 atm, and volume already written, density is equal to 1. Okay, this is about total container. I am talking about entire container, these are the parameters. If I am separating it into this half part, okay, now volume what it is, it will be 2.5, and what is the mass, it is going to be 2.5 kg. okay, mass and volume both are separated, but temperature it is how much, still it is 27 degrees Celsius only, and pressure is still how much, 1 atm only, density is still how much, 1. Okay, so these three parameters have no change, then they are counted as what, intensity property. What they are counted as, intensity property. See, on making the quantity half, these values also changed, therefore extensive property, volume and mass are extensive property, and whereas temperature, pressure, density, if you have this concept in mind, let them give any questions, you will be able to answer. Is it understood? Simple one technique I will tell you. Ratio of two extensive property, extensive divided by extensive, then the answer is going to be intensive. Answer is going to be what? Intensive. Okay, for example, mass was extensive, volume was extensive, but mass by volume what it is, density, density will become as a intensive, density will become as intensive. Okay, suppose heat capacity, heat capacity is amount of heat required to increase the temperature by 1 degree Celsius. Okay, so this is what extensive, understood, and 1 gram. So I am dividing it with the mass. Okay, mass, this is also extensive, but on dividing both of them, whatever I am getting, it is called as a specific heat capacity. What it is called as? Specific heat capacity, but it is going to be what? Intensive. Okay, ratio of two extensive properties, ratio of two extensive property will be intensive property. Is it understood? Any doubt about this? Okay, this is about the ratio, understood, and intensive property, not additive, not additive. Okay, suppose one container is there 27 degree Celsius, another container is 27 degree Celsius. When I keep both of them, the temperature is not 54 degree Celsius. Is it correct? No, temperature is still 27 degree Celsius only. Is it understood? And density, suppose it was 1 and it is 3. So if I keep both of them, what is the density? Is it 4? No, it is 2. How it is? 2, 3 plus 1 by 2. So that's why you cannot add two intensive properties directly. Is it understood? So, but they can be added. Suppose this is 1 kg, that is 1 kg. So add them 2 kgs. Okay. So these extensive properties are additive. E plus E. Okay. E plus I. Not okay. I means intensive. I plus I, not okay. Okay, but you can divide both of them, no problem. Is it understood? So this is about the extensive property and intensive property, I am going to give you the some tabular form of the extensive and intensive. If you understand the concept, then need not to memorize. Otherwise, I will give you chance to memorize also. Okay? So wait for some time, and I am going to give you the tabular form. Okay, these are the some classification of examples of extensive and intensive. On careful observation, pressure, temperature, volume, mass, I have clearly explained through the lively examples. See, moles, more quantity, more will be the moles. Understood? Enthalpy, entropy, free energy, internal energy. Enthalpy is denoted with, this you are going to study in detail in future classes. Entropy denoted with S, free energy denoted with G, okay, and internal energy somewhere it is written U, somewhere it is written E, okay. So these you don't worry, for the time being you should remember they are the extensive properties. See here, molar volume, volume occupied per mole, that means volume is extensive, mole is extensive, therefore it is going to be intensive. Mass by volume, this is also I have explained here. Refractive index, surface tension, that is force per unit area, perpendicular, per word is, wherever there is a per word is used, that will become as a intensive, it is a technique, okay. Viscosity, free energy per mole, here also I have written, free energy, not mentioned how much it is, then it is extensive, free energy for one mole, then it is per mole. Heat capacity is extensive, but specific heat capacity, molar heat capacity will become as an intensive property. Boiling point and freezing point. What is the boiling point of 1 kg water? And same as boiling point of 2 kg water also, 5 kg water also, water boiling point is fixed. It does not depend on the quantity. Same is the freezing point. This is also does not depend on the quantities. These are the some examples, extensive and intensive properties. I think it is now exactly clear, accurately clear to you. Let any question comes, if you know about that quantity, you will be able to segregate them into extensive and intensive. Okay, so make a note of it. Okay, next is state of a system. Okay, state of a system means there are certain set of variables. There are certain set of variable which describe the system, which are used to describe the system. Okay, so that is called as a state of the system. Suppose the system is at pressure of 1 atm and occupying 10 liter, temperature of 273 Kelvin. So these are the state variables. Okay. And these variables will give you describe about the system. That description is called as a state of the system. Okay. So this is about the state function. Sorry, state system, state of the system. And when you write all of them, there will be some function. There will be some parameters. So those parameters are either classified as a state function or classified as a path function. Okay. What is the difference between state function and path function? If a function or a variable or a parameter follows the three conditions. What are those three conditions? It depends only on initial and final state, but not on path followed by it. Then it is called as a state function. Okay. So that means let us take how many marks you got. Okay, what was the previous marks? Last time you got 30 marks and this time you got 40 marks. Then there, your parents are interested about your only state function. If they ask, was the exam was easy or was the exam was tough, was the exam was mains or advanced, they are worried about the path, what is the condition. Are you copied and got the good marks or it was sincere efforts? So then it will be a path function. Understood? How you got this much marks? If they are worried, that means it is a path function. No, what is there any improvement or there or not? What was the chapter? They are not worried. Okay, difficult chapter was this time. otherwise your health was not okay. So they are not worried why there is no improvement, why there is suppose you got 20, they are going to scold you. That means they are state function. So if they are asking why it was less, why it was a difficult questions, or you could not do it well because of the health problem, if they are worried about the path, then they are following which function? Path function. Okay. So the functions are the variable which depend only on initial and final state. Okay, that was a real life example I took. Now I am going to take as actual function. Okay, actual example. Let us take there is one object at zero height. Therefore, potential energy is going to be how much? Zero. So let us take, if we are taking it to the height h, then potential energy is going to be mgh. Is it understood? So, but I am not worried. I brought it in this way. Okay, I brought it in this way. The still potential energy is going to be same. But if I bring it in this direction, this is the path 1, this is the path 2, this is the path 3. So, I have to work more in the path 3 and less work in the path 1. That means work in the 3 greater than, work in the 2 greater than, work in the 1. So, it depends upon the direction, how I went from this place to that place. This is a what function? Path function. I am not worried how much height you brought it, just tell me. Then it will be a, this potential energy is going to be what function? State function. State function and path function, now is it clear? So first condition is, it depends only on initial and final but not on path. If it is a cyclic process, all path function, state function, delta is going to be change in, state function is going to be zero. Okay. Euler's reciprocity theorem must be satisfied. This you will study in other subject, but as an additional information I wanted to inform you. So I am going to give you some examples. I have made you understand the concept now. Okay, now what I am doing, I am going to give you some examples. Here it is state function, here it is which function? Path function. Okay, examples are pressure, volume, temperature, Gibbs free energy, internal energy, enthalpy. These are the some examples of state function. Pressure, volume, temperature, Gibbs free energy are simple free energy we can say. Okay. Internal energy and enthalpy. Here path function. What is the path function? Like potential energy also. Same state function. Okay. Work, heat, friction, energy lost due to the friction. If you are doing it in a nice way, friction energy lost will be zero. Okay. And but the same thing, this is the most confusing question. If they are asking about the P, then it is a state function. Change in pressure, it is not a state function, it is a path function. Change in volume, the path function. Change in temperature, path function. Change in enthalpy, path function. Change in entropy, path function. Change in free energy, path function. As soon as I put delta, that will become as a path function. Otherwise, they will be state function. Is it understood? Any doubt about this? Even entropy, entropy also will be here only. Okay. So these are the state function, these are the path function. Any doubt about this? I don't think you got any doubt as of now. Okay. Now let us further move to the types of thermodynamic process. What is the next topic we are going to cover? Thermodynamic process. Okay. Types of thermodynamic process. Okay. There are many types of thermodynamic process. Okay. First one is isothermal. The name itself will tell you. What is the isothermal? The process which is carried out at constant temperature is called as isothermal. So whenever in the numerical, if they are giving isothermal, that means wherever the formula is there, delta T, how much you should substitute? Zero. Then coming to the adiabatic. Which batic? Adiabatic. where heat is constant. What is constant? Heat energy is constant. Therefore, delta Q will be zero. Okay. But temperature may increase, temperature may decrease. Suppose if we are carrying out some combustion reaction in a thermally insulated container, then the temperature of that system will increase. If you are dissolving some substance which requires heat energy, outside it is not going to come, so temperature will decrease. So temperature may increase or decrease, but what will be fixed? Heat energy is going to be fixed. Delta Q is going to be zero. Okay. Next it is isobaric. What it is? Isobaric. Okay. So what will be bar means pressure unit. That's why what must be constant? Pressure must be constant. So delta P is going to be zero. So to keep the pressure constant, volume may increase, volume may decrease. Suppose if you are heating a system in this container, here it is, what it is? Closed. Now if you are heating, then what will be energy? Heat energy will be increasing, so delta Q is not equal to zero. That is what heat energy will be increasing, non-adiabatic. Okay. And pressure will increase, so not isobaric. But volume is fixed, then it is isochoric. What it is? Isochoric. But if I open this lid, then it will expand. To keep what? To keep the pressure constant. Okay. So if the reactions are carried out without lid, otherwise simply we can say open container, otherwise movable piston. Okay. If the question they gives movable piston, frictionless piston, that means it is isobaric. Okay. So to keep the pressure constant, it can move up and down. If no lid at all, then always it is 1 atm. Okay. So that is isobaric. They will not give you it is isobaric. You have to identify the numericals with the, if they are giving movable piston and open, that means he is giving a hint to take delta P as a zero. Okay. What is the next? Isochoric. So isochoric, what will be fixed? Volume is constant. Okay. Volume constant means delta V is equal to zero. So work done will be what? Zero. Because there is no moving up, there is no moving down. Therefore, isochoric process, volume also constant and work done also will be zero. Okay. So next one, it is cyclic process. After this, what is the next one? Cyclic. Okay. So cyclic process means initial state is equal to what state? Final state. If in a reaction initial state exactly matches to final state, then it is called as a cyclic process. What it is called as? Cyclic process. Okay. Now second one is reversible and irreversible. Irreversible. Okay. If a process is carried out infinitesimally, what decimally? Infinitesimally, slowly, then it is called as a reversible. If it is carried out in a fast manner, then it is called as a irreversible process. Here work will be maximum, here work will not be maximum. Here system will be in equilibrium with surroundings. Okay. System is not in equilibrium with surroundings. Is it understood? And delta P is almost equal to zero. Delta P is very, very, very large. Okay. So if there is expansion, sudden expansion, there is a contraction, there is sudden compression. So that means large difference is there. Small difference is there. Therefore, delta P is equal to zero. That means P system is equal to P surrounding. Okay. Reversible and irreversible, is it understood? So these are some. And isoenthalpic. What is the next one? Isoenthalpic. That means delta H. Enthalpy change is zero. Or enthalpy is constant. But what is enthalpy? If you don't know, then at this time it is difficult for you to understand. Okay, so these are the types of process: isothermal, adiabatic, isochoric, isobaric, cyclic, reversible, irreversible, and isoenthalpic. Okay, is it understood? So next, let us take about the next topic. What is the next topic? Thermodynamic equilibrium. Next topic is what? Thermodynamic equilibrium. Okay. So people have the wrong meaning. Thermodynamic equilibrium. Okay. Thermodynamic equilibrium. So the equilibrium which contains three further equilibrium. Okay. A system is said to be at thermodynamic equilibrium when it is at three further equilibriums. What are the three further equilibriums? First one is thermal equilibrium. See, this word both appear to be very same, but they are not same. Okay, thermal equilibrium. Next one is mechanical equilibrium. Okay, what is the next one? Mechanical equilibrium. And after that it is chemical equilibrium. Okay, when these three equilibrium coexist. Okay, so as a short form I will write EQBM. Is it understood? And it is also EQBM. It is also EQBM. Okay, thermal equilibrium, mechanical equilibrium, and chemical equilibrium. If all three coexist, then only we will say it as a thermodynamic equilibrium. Okay, but you should know what is thermal equilibrium. Suppose this is a system. This is what? Surrounding. Okay, this is what? System. Understood? So there is no temperature flow, there is no heat flow. Understood? Heat is neither going out nor coming in, and temperature is maintained constant. Then suppose heat is going out, temperature will decrease. Heat is coming into the system, temperature will increase. Okay, so increase or decrease is not taking place, then it is called as a thermal equilibrium. Okay, so when there is no change in the temperature, okay, there is no change in the temperature between the system and surrounding, there is no exchange of heat energy between the system and surrounding, then this is called as thermal equilibrium. Okay, there is no expansion or contraction. Okay, there is no expansion. It is a movable piston only. There is no expansion and contraction when you are maintaining in a system in a movable container. Okay, then it is called as a mechanical equilibrium. So work done will be zero here, delta Q will be zero here. Okay, delta Q is going to be zero here if there is no change in composition. What is the chemical composition? There is no change. Okay, where there is no chemical change in composition. Okay, no chemical composition change, then it is called as a chemical equilibrium. Okay, chemical equilibrium, mechanical equilibrium, and thermodynamic equilibrium, if all of them coexist, then only it is called as a thermodynamic equilibrium. Is it understood? Now we are going to study about the first thermodynamics law. It is not first law of thermodynamics, first thermodynamics law. Okay, that is zeroth law of thermodynamics. What is that? Zeroth law of thermodynamic. Okay, let us take we are going to study which law? Zeroth law of thermodynamics. Okay, so let us take two system. What it is? A and B. Two system. Okay, and two system are in thermal equilibrium. Two system are in thermal equilibrium. Thermal, not thermodynamic. Thermal. So they both will be, suppose these two are thermal equilibrium. So these two also thermal equilibrium. Sorry, this is C. Okay, so A and C are in thermal equilibrium, B and C are thermal equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium means both temperatures are same. let us take this is at 300 degree Celsius, this is also should be 300 degree Celsius, because if I take it as 350, then heat will flow this, we cannot say it is thermally equilibrium. Okay, so this is 300 and these two are also thermal equilibrium, means that means this is also 300 degree Celsius. Obviously, indirectly we can say these two are also in thermal equilibrium with each other. So zeroth law of thermodynamics says that when two system are in separately thermodynamic equilibrium with the third system, then they themselves are also in the thermodynamic equilibrium. This is about the zeroth law of thermodynamics. Okay, so I think it is clear to you everybody now. Thermodynamics, you should feel it is easy, because I have took lot of pain and lot of good examples, lively examples, so that it should be easy for you. Most of the people worry about the thermodynamics because they are not getting explanation in that direction. Okay, so I think we will close this session now itself, and you will close this session by doing the two things: give a like and share it to your friends. Okay, bye bye, see you with the next session.